Okay, so I haven't started this video yet properly. This is actually me in post commentary. I just need to warn you all that around the second half of this video, I get really, really frustrated at ranked and, my teammates' incompetence, yada, yada, yada. There are some swear words. I censored them, but most people can probably make out what I said. And this isn't the worst. It gets so much more worse in future videos. You guys have no idea. But just want to warn you all that I will get frustrated towards the end, and that's just a consequence of playing ranked on Splatoon with people who don't know how to play. Please try to enjoy the video despite my frustration. Or because of it, I guess. Alright, that was a pretty long break. It's been several hours since last time. And the rotation changed to splat zones on Salt Spray Rig and Blackbelly Skate Park. I'm not really feeling it playing with the custom E-Leader for this mode on these maps, but let's try it. It's more that I'm on A+. I'm expecting a huge burst of talent now. I imagine if I drop a rank, it's gonna kick me out again, then I'm gonna have to get back to A+. Yeah. I'm actually. There's no S minus. Someone suggested that there was an S minus. There is none. It jumps straight to S, then S plus. And yes, there is only one splat zone in Salt Spray Rig. This is the. Wow! Just a bunch of charges here, except for the tent attack over there. Hopefully, these are the classic ones. Oh goodness. Did they both get splatted? Okay. Now we're in control. Just gonna throw some squid beacons all over and jump up here. Yes, we have taken the lead. And we just have to protect from here. This is actually a really easy map to dominate in, unfortunately enough. Which is kind of lame, even for the opponents. But it is what it is. Another squid beacon right here. Jump back up. Come on, splat him. Splat her. They're squippers, so they have to aim perfectly if they want to actually do this. Okay, managed to find them. Ah! But 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, that was dominating, but that's because that's how Salt Spray Rig is. I keep thinking, when we were like dominating like that, I keep thinking. The opponents lost a player. Cool. 12 points. Not 10, 12, because they had a next ranker. Oh, come on. Don't. S wh Your shots can get blocked by players standing in front of you. That's so aggravating. Jeez. And they got splatted twice again! Come on! Yeah, they were setting up base behind here. I think we will too. The maps are huge, and this one, everything gets focused on the center, so it's easy to like get to the back there and set up a camp with the squid beacon, so you can attack from multiple sides instead of just one. Okay, I'm kind of lagging a bit. I should have been able to splat that player, though. Thank goodness for that squid beacon back there. Well, splatted that player, and the squid beacon still remains. One of the shticks about splat zones. Oh, really? Oh, well, he splatted him. I see you! Ah, missed! Come on, we have to get. If we gain control, they'll be humongously punished for. Like, splat zones is weird. There's actually, like, some kind of, like, punishment for completely losing control. There, got you. There's another one right there. Ah! I hate when they manage to. When my squid beacon actually saved the day. And we're getting back control, good. That means they got punished with a bunch of extra time. That's how it works in splat zones. When you lose control, you lose lots of time. It's a bit... I don't know how the calculation works specifically, but that's how it is. Yes, we're in control thanks to the Splash-O-Matic, or rather the Suction Bomb Special. It's one of the best ones for this type of game, anyway. I'm not being very useful right now because of my position. Gotta go back up here. Ah, dang it. Spotted you. Finally got my... go. Oh! Smarmy. No. Got you. But be accurate with my shots. Don't we have control yet? Jeez. Ah! Aim just right. And not go straight into the splat bomb. Jeez. We're about to go over into overtime. We still have the advantage. We have to keep it, though. Almost squid-ed into the abyss down there. Keep control. Yep. Got you. Got you. Ah, dang it. Okay, we win. Because going into overtime and the players with the advantage have control, that means there's no overtime. You just instantly win. Not a complete knockout, but a win is a win. And you don't get rewarded with as much. But still a lot of points. And it's 12 points because they had more A-plus players than we did. Is the game trying to set teams up against me? But I keep winning anyway because... I mean, I play like an S player, I guess? I don't know. I'm getting lucky. And that's what I feel. A bunch of S players. Well, I sure feel confident. Oh, Salt Spray Rig again. Yeah, that's where my luck really lies. The fact that we keep playing on Salt Spray Rig. And it's all Japanese players. Well, all except me and that, the power. Oh, dang it, Bubbler. Kraken. Yep. You're doomed. And we are dominating right now. Jeez. Thought you could escape me. Okay, we're about to win instantly. Jeez. Because we got really lucky with the KOs and whatever. Yeah. So that was... did I get all the yes players? Yes, I did. Okay. No wonder. In that case, we're only getting 8 points because that was way too good. The players on my team, that is. If S players play this well, I can only wonder how well S plus players must be. Jeez. We're still... I kind of want to do Black Billy Skate Park at least once to show how it is when there's two splat zones. It's a lot more interesting when there's two splat zones. A lot more tug of war style. Okay, cool. Although Black Valley Skate Park, the two splat zones are right next to each other, so I think Port Mackerel is probably the best map to show how it is tug of war style. Try to surprise us. Yeah, we're in control. Okay, time to set up some squid beacons. And they're in control already? Jeez. And they're everywhere. You are out. You are out. Well, it's not that bad a move because Ink Strikes instantly turn her... Oh, really? Come on. You want to splat me. And you did, but well, it can't be helped. Ink Strikes, yeah. I see lots of Ink Strikes. Oh, really? How did I not hit you? Oh my goodness. You hit far. Oh, yeah, they're not stupid. And I am, though. What I mean by they're not stupid is that the player with the Inkzooka knew that they could just not use the Inkzooka. Got you. Oh, come on. How did I... Well, it is a Black Billy Skate Park. Got you. There's not much spots where I can keep my distance is the problem here. Part of the reason why I didn't want to use the custom E-leader in a map like this. Okay, good. This is a good spot. Part of the reason why I don't like Inkzookas, but we're sticking around. I was about to super jump to my allies. They completely lost control. Bucket. Got you. It's almost always going to go into overtime. In Black Bailey Skate Park. Come on. We have to keep out control so we can win overtime. Ooh. Dang it. And they've won that. Unless we... No, if we gain control. No, we're not going to do it. We have to be in control to win, to like keep ourselves in overtime. So yeah, that's my first loss. A narrow loss, but a loss nonetheless. Part of the reason because they were using so many blasters. Black Billy Skate Park really favors blasters like this. Very aggravating. And Justin, geez, 15 splats. Anyway, that's 10 points lost. That's not so bad, I guess. It could be worse. Ooh, that player knows. Ah, trying to hit him. Really? What happened here? Player just went straight into our base? Got you, and got you. Hurry up, ink the place. Okay. Do you have squid beacons? Yes. Crack on splat roller, dang it. What? What is that player doing? He's right there. Oh, no wonder. I was like wondering, what the hell is that player doing? Why is it not trying to splat him? And of course he's invincible. Okay, we see the position. Don't know why that player thinks he can outrange me. Yep, always squid form. Oh, I should have crouched. But, oh, we won. they were so focused on splatting us, they kept forgetting to ink over our zone. Huh. Well, that was an interesting match. Like, when it comes to splatting each other, we're equal, but we're the ones who kept control of the zone the entire time. Okay, just 10 points. I imagine if they had... 3A plus players and the S player, that would have been 12 points for us. If I keep getting Salt Spray Rig like this, I feel confident I can reach S in less than an hour, that's for sure. Wow! Just Charger Mania over here! Even the enemies have a charger. Trying to reach that player back here. I almost had him. Oh, jeez. Thank you. No, you won't get me. Ha! Cold-blooded. Some people will recommend using cold-blooded with a... charger like this? I don't think so. I don't agree. And that was my bad. Out of places to hide. Okay, that player back there is keeping things under his control because of how he's positioned. Ah! He's trying to hit that player, but it's scope variant, jeez. Crap! They've taken the lead, but they've lost control. And we're now we're in control. We have to gain back at least 1 point, and then we can stick around where we are. Okay, I really like that one player at least got the echolocator. Almost had you. Got you! Someone with a Kraken? Yes. Or, no, someone's coming! Ah! Well, we have the advantage, that's what's important. We have to keep control for a good minute or so, though. Oh my goodness, why didn't I freaking crack in? Oh my goodness, we just got ganked there. Jeez. I guess I'm gonna be stuck in a hell right here. Because there's no way we're winning this game now. And they only have the advantage by 1 point, no less. Jeez. Outrageous. It's partly my fault, though. There are several instances where I should have, like, gotten my Kraken and just activated as soon as it happened, but no, I messed him up. At least I'm the top player. Unfortunately, it's only 10 points I'm losing, not any more than that, but... ugh! I hate... this is the aggravation of ranked. Getting stuck in a hell where you can see win and then lose and then win and then lose and you don't really change your position, ever. Of course, it's even more aggravating if you keep losing, because that means more times you have to win. And if you drop a rank, it's... oh, wow, S+. Huh. If you drop a rank, it's back to 30 points on the previous rank, I think. Either that or 70 points. I'm not positive what, but... you don't go drop to, like, just 98 or something. And there's so many freaking decos. God dang it. Anyway, yeah. This is optimal point. And wow, really? That color? Absolutely hate it. Come on, show yourselves! Oh my goodness, that was my bad. I didn't mean to drop down there. And that's the S+ player. Carbon roller, huh? That player is just trying to build up his meter. And really? I see you. Nice try, but you didn't get me. Part of the weakness of Carbon Roller. And I see that player. He's ninjaing all over the place. Oh my goodness. One splat, and I could have gotten him. For a sword, we're only going to be using 8 points. Come on, almost had him. I hit that player, but not quite enough to splat him. There. Oh, I splat him. Someone's coming up. Thank you. We're standing strong, but yeah. That wasn't gonna work. I don't know why I did that. Don't know why he did that. I guess he was really being extra aggressive for once. That was a very accurate shot I did there. Sometimes I surprise myself. Oh my goodness, we have to stay in control! And, well, with the S Plus player, this clearly wasn't going to be our win, because he knows the ins and out of how to play on this map specifically. And Carbon Roller, I mean, goodness gracious, that definitely advantages Splatzone players, but... Well, there's no buts, really, we just got outplayed, honestly. Oh my goodness, seriously? Oh, they had the S Plus player, but because we have more S players and A Plus players, we lose more points. Oh, come on. You have to splat the foes for us? That was way too obvious. Don't know what that player was trying. And we obviously lost control. Oh my goodness. Duh. Come on down. Price is right. Oh my goodness. I hate how f***ing rollers don't have to aim! God! What are they doing? Goodness! Take my time, take a deep breath. Don't let them through. I'm wondering where that there was a Dynamo player that went down there. I'm wondering where he's doing right now. Just fooling around, whatever. Oh my goodness! What a waste! Get control! We have to get control! Cool, double splat. My goodness, how do we keep losing control? Bye! There! How do we not have control? There! Jeez! It gives us ample more time. Whew. So stressful. Goodness gracious. I mean, yeah, there was that one screw-up I did with the Kraken, where I just went straight into the pit while activating it, which is probably the worst move I could have done, but I don't know what they were doing for a majority of this match. Getting splatted, I suppose. The opponents, they were pretty much doing the same thing, just continuously getting themselves splatted. Or rather, I'm pretty sure they had quick respawn on, which is why they kept suiciding on us. By effectively keeping to, like, super jump straight back into the action when we had our, or I had my sights on them at the very least. Can't do that. Ah. Cool, thank you. Oh my goodness, the range on that weapon. Outrageous! Don't know why he didn't notice. And that was me getting completely screwed by a bunch of specials. My squid beacon's still up there, but they're getting to it. Just waiting for us! Oh, come on! Did I get the punch of players who don't know how to not die? Oh, god damn it! What a load of bullshit! And I'm stopping the video right here. So, as some of you may have noticed, this is the beginning of my frustration at my teammates, or some of my teammates, during my ranked quest to S+, even though I only reach S. If you guys thought that was bad, it gets much worse later on. And I'm stopping this video here when I actually probably originally expected that I would, like, do an entire video when using my Splat Zone footage, but I only used roughly 1/3. I think I'll be able to compress the rest of the 1 hour and 10 minutes in around half an hour because my commentary is much more sparse then, but there's lots of little moments that I'll probably show anyway. Besides that, well, I hope you all somehow enjoyed this video, or maybe the first half, so where I was relatively calm, but for the next video, don't expect me to get any nicer. I get really, really upset. Particularly towards a certain player. Anyway, check the playlist for more Splatoon. Otherwise, please have a nice day. Bye-bye.